Good afternoon, everyone. Well, you're looking a little bit different than the last time I saw you about a month ago. All right, my name is Mary Kerr, in case you don't remember. I met you about a month ago. I'm the dean for the School of Nursing. And it's been a month since Prepare to Care. It's been a month since you came on board and you entered Case Western Reserve. It's been a month since you've met your roommate. How's it gone? A little bit of a whirlwind, hasn't it? A little different than high school, would you say? Yes. Okay. So one of the things I wanted to let you know about is we are live streaming this. Did you know that? We have two cameras going on. And so what I'd like you to do is turn around and say hello to your family and friends. This is going on YouTube. So hello, come on, say hello. Oh, you can do better than that. One, two, three, say hi.
Hi.
There you go. Thank you. Well, we're actually gathered here for a serious ceremony, all right? And so I wanted to take a moment out of your very busy schedules to honor another first in your nursing career. Your first interactions with patients. Being a nurse, interacting with patients is more than a job. It's an honor and a privilege. I say that because as a nursing student, your learning environment and your workplace is more than just being in the hospital or being in a clinic. It's different than your engineering friends and your law friends. It's different than any of those. Okay, the difference is you are going to receive an invitation. You are receiving an invitation into patients' lives and into the lives of their families. And you will become part of their lives. You are invited at their happiest points. At the birth of their child. You're going to be invited into their lives when they are the most vulnerable, when they're incapacitated from illness and from grief. And as a nurse, your workspace is more than a computer or a desk or a lab. It's your patient's personal space. It is their physical, social, and spiritual being. It's their bodies. And so your stethoscope is an extension of you. It signifies this physical and spiritual and personal connection that you will have to your patients. And so as a nurse or nursing student, you are invited into and intruding into someone else's world. And the stethoscope ceremony is a way to remind you to tread lightly, respectfully, and with purpose. One of the things I wanted to do was have our purpose up there, but that's okay, I'll tell you. The purpose at Francis Payne Bolton is summed up by our mission, okay? And this mission is really critical to what you're doing. The mission of the school is to provide leadership. Okay. You will become a nursing leader, and you've heard that already. But it's leadership in terms of innovation, research, education, and practice. You will promote the health of human beings, and you will reduce their burden of disease. Reduce the burden of disease. That is powerful stuff. Our mission is dedicated to interdisciplinary scholarship. You are going to work as a member of a team, and you are committed to the pursuit of excellence in service, both here in Cleveland, regionally, nationally, and globally. And so, as an FPB student and future nurse leader, you are part of that pursuit of excellence. And in 4 short years, minus 1 month, you will be part of that legacy. I am looking forward to discovering your contributions during your stay at FPB and beyond. Thank you. Now, go ahead and applaud. Yay! And now I would like to introduce Lauren Jakowski, instructor and advisor for first-year students, and she's going to talk a little bit more about today's ceremony.
Thank you very much. It's so nice to see all of you in your beautiful community uniforms, and it's nice to be together here. As Tiona said, she feels the love. So I feel the love too, and it's a beautiful thing. So I'm pleased to be here to share this beautiful ceremony with you. Ceremonies like weddings and birthdays mark important points in our lives, and they represent life transitions. Nurses have always held ceremonies to mark important points in our professional formation. Today's ritual formalizes an educational milestone for you. The Francis Payne Bolton School of Nursing class of 2019 has met the requirements to participate in patient care in the hospital. The faculty recognizes the hours of preparation required to get you to this point. You are familiar with all the hospital requirements, the background checks, the immunizations, the hospital safety modules, the EMR training. All of those are important. You've also started in your nursing courses, the fundamentals of practice, including practicing skills in the Learning Resource Center, even interviewing standardized patients. Your preparation in your other nursing courses, Nursing 110, learning about exploring models of care, nursing roles, and theorists. And of course, I can't leave out your basic sciences education in Bio 114 and anatomy and physiology. So we know you're ready. In the weeks ahead, you'll finally use your stethoscopes with real patients. When you use and wear your stethoscope, others recognize your special knowledge and skills. One of your clinical instructors, Mary Varieth, put it beautifully to me. She said, receiving the stethoscope is a symbol of acceptance of the responsibility to safeguard human lives. I thought metaphorically, as first-year nursing students at this point, you're kind of standing in an open doorway. As you progress beyond this liminal point, you'll experience some separation, kind of your past life as a teenager, as a more dependent student, and you're going to move to a transition period, which you're kind of in now, of learning new skills and taking on new responsibilities, and eventually there's a period of incorporation into the profession. And I believe that this moment in time is worthy of our collective attention, so we assemble together to celebrate this rite of passage. I ask that you just take a minute now to kind of take in the beauty of this moment. You may want to close your eyes or focus on the nightingale lamp there, and just pause and reflect kind of on where you are right now in your education and in your life. And I think with reflection, we can look forward with anticipation of the knowledge, skills, and professional growth just beyond this doorway where you now sit. So I just welcome you and enjoy the exhilarating ride ahead. I wanted to introduce Frances Do Rosario, you know, is the president of the Undergraduate Student Nurses Association, and she's going to share her thoughts on the stethoscope. Thank you.
Hi everyone. Well, first I just want to say congratulations on beginning the journey that is nursing school. I can still remember my very first day of clinical, pacing back and forth outside my patient's room, being scared to even knock on the door. And I was a first year student then with essentially no nursing skills and a fear of even having a conversation with the patient. A lot has changed since then. Well, first, my scrubs have never been that white since, but standing before you now as a junior, I can attest to the growth and empowerment that Francis Payne Bolton provides. You'll be amazed at how confident you'll become. Eventually, your stethoscope will feel like a natural extension of yourself. Accepting your stethoscope today also comes with a lot of responsibility. You are the future of healthcare, and the passion and empathy you bring to patients has a tremendous impact. You may not carry BSNRN on your name tag yet, but trust that you are making a difference. Patients value everything you do, even if it's as simple as taking the time to talk to them. Among all the blood, sweat, and tears, and I'm not just talking about the patients, I suggest always taking a step back and remembering why you chose nursing in the first place. I'm not sure if anyone watched the Miss America pageant this year, but one contestant performed a monologue that nurses across the nation really appreciated. She reminisced about her first patient Joe, who was suffering from Alzheimer's. One day, Joe told her, "Although you say it all the time, you are not just a nurse. You are my nurse, and you have changed my life because you have cared about me." That is the power that we have as nurses, and my advice would be to remember this fact no matter what you're doing. There are a lot of beautiful moments you'll experience during your time here, helping a patient take their first steps after surgery, watching a birth, or seeing a patient's grateful expression after a bed bath. I urge you all to continue finding purpose in your passion and take advantage of all the opportunities to learn. It's a truly amazing feeling when everything you're taught starts to coalesce. So congratulations and have a great year. And now I'd like to introduce Reverend Barbara Essex from the Office of Student Affairs on the Interreligious Council.
Good afternoon. To Dean Kerr and to the staff and faculty of the Francis Payne Bolton School of Nursing, to your friends and families, and especially to our students, thank you for the invitation to be with you this afternoon. I am honored to share this exciting day with you. I want to begin with a confession. I love social media. Partly because I don't have to be in real time to know what's happening in the world. So there I was last week scrolling through my Facebook news feed when I saw a post about nurses and their allies protesting remarks made on The View. The post carried the dramatic hashtag Nurses Unite. And I thought, who would have the nerve to mess with nurses? I mean, who does that? I followed the conversation thread backwards to the Miss America pageant 2016 that was held on September 13th. I was puzzled. What does nursing have to do with Miss America? Well, with a few simple clicks, I was transported back to the televised event, to the talent part of the pageant, as Francis just said. There was Miss Colorado coming to the stage in her scrubs and stethoscope. For her talent, she related the story that occurred between her and one of her patients. The point of her presentation was that nursing is a talent, a skill, a science, and an art. Kelly Johnson is more than just a nurse, and her patient is more than his diagnosis. I was moved to tears because I understood what she was getting at in her presentation. The hosts of The View made insensitive remarks about Ms. Johnson's choice of talent. One host even asked, "Why is she wearing a doctor's stethoscope?" Regardless of how you may feel about beauty contests or The View, the incident is significant for at least a few reasons. First, it highlighted the diversity of backgrounds of the pageant contestants. I had not watched a pageant in years and had never given much thought about who they were and what their backgrounds were. Secondly, the incident placed the spotlight on one of the most important yet publicly neglected professions. Nurses rock. Everybody knows that. Thirdly, it raised the awareness of who nurses are, what they do, and the gifts they bring to the profession. And finally, it has motivated many of us to thank, affirm, and appreciate the nurses in our lives who make great sacrifices to care for us. And how amazing is it that on the heels of the Miss America pageant, you will be receiving your stethoscopes today, signaling your readiness for direct patient care. Over the course of your academic career, you will learn about anatomy, physiology, pharmacology, biology, and other medical and health sciences. You will learn all aspects of medicine and patient care. You will work long hours in and out of class, in your clinical settings, and still manage to do your laundry, clean your room, balance your checkbook, and keep up with your social media networks. You will see, smell, and touch things us non-nursing folks can't even imagine or care to imagine. You will care for pleasant people and those who will push the limits of your patients. You will fret over exams, papers, projects, and all those lab reports. You will feel unsure about your techniques and insecure when standing at the bedside of your patients. You may wonder why you're pursuing nursing at all. All of these feelings, joy, confidence, uncertainty, and fatigue are normal and part of the process of becoming a nurse. Over the course of your studies, please remember that you are part of a profession that holds compassion and caring and healing as three of its central ideals and values. You are joining a group of women and men who are pledging to care for people, all people, no matter what the setting. As a nurse, you may find yourself in all kinds of places. Hospitals, schools, prisons, clinics, even makeshift triage tents in refugee camps. You will be first responders after fires and earthquakes, hurricanes and tornadoes and tsunamis. You will be on the front lines in times of war and peace. You will be educating parents on how to care for themselves and their children. Every hour of every day, you will be there for others, bringing life and healing to many, and comfort for the dying and those who are left behind. In every setting, you will make a difference. You are more than just a nurse. I want to share two stories with you from my own life. In June 1984, probably long before any of you were born, my father was taken to the hospital. He had been diagnosed terminal after a reoccurrence of his lung cancer. I left work and went to the hospital to see him, and as I approached his room, I noticed the door was closed. My heart started to pound because a closed door did not bode well. As I touched the door to open it, one of the nurses stopped me. She left her station and walked over to me. She gently told me that my father had died an hour ago and that the rest of our family had already left for home. She stood with me and watched me carefully. She would not let me go until she was assured that I was okay and could make my way back home. In that moment, she was more than a nurse. She comforted me. She offered me a shoulder to lean on and to cry on. And she offered strong arms to hug me back into calmness so that I could get myself home. More than a nurse. In February 2002, I underwent surgery for colon cancer. It was the nursing staff that cared for me that first weekend after my surgery. It was Melvin who taught me how to breathe through my pain. It was Sylvia who showed me how to release the pain medication through the IV drip next to my bed. It was Carmen who showed me how to place a pillow on my abdomen so that I could get up and sit down without too much pain. It was Lisa who told me to get up and walk shortly after my surgery, showing me how to use my IV drip stand as a cane. The nursing staff helped me relearn how to care for myself, how to administer the meds once I got back home, what I should eat and what I should avoid once I was on my own. It was the nursing staff who cheered and celebrated when I was discharged from their care. I want to believe that they were happy that I was going home, as opposed to, yeah, we're finally getting rid of her. Each and every one was more than a nurse. They were my caregivers, my confidants, my cheerleaders, my support, and for that brief stay, they were my family. So, here's the thing. Nurses operate in real time, in the moment, on the spot. In healthcare situations, you bring together all that is in your heads and your hearts, and your hands are the gifts that we all need and have come to trust. You make a difference every time you interact with a patient. We trust you to take good care of us. We rely on your expertise to help us heal. We need you to translate medical terms into words we can understand. We believe you when you educate us on how to live better and more comfortably. We feel your compassion when we are dying. We are comforted by your words to our families about what the future is likely to hold for us. You are the calming presence in the midst of strong emotions, fear, and chaos. You are always more than just a nurse. I am fortunate to have nurses in my life and in my family. My best friend is a nurse. My youngest sister is a nurse. And my nephew and niece have just started their first year of nursing school in Indiana. I know the sacrifices that will be made to pursue this profession. 12-hour shifts, working weekends and holidays, standing on your feet for long hours at a time, dealing with uncooperative patients and sometimes coworkers. I respect and admire your commitment and your dedication. I will be thinking of you in the days ahead, and I will be sending you my best wishes for your futures. My hope is that you will learn to love what you do, that you will find ways to love those for whom you care, and that you will always have someone cheering, affirming, and supporting you along the way. In a few minutes, you will receive your stethoscopes and pledge your commitment to the profession that has chosen you. I am so proud of you for what you have already accomplished and what you will accomplish. You are more than nurses. You rock. Congratulations on reaching this milestone, and all the best as you move forward in your careers. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Essex. Good afternoon. My name is Jessie Honsky, and I am the Assistant Director of the BSN program. It is such a pleasure to be a part of this ceremony with you today. We have come to the presentation of the stethoscopes. You may notice the stethoscopes come in different colors. Please wait until after the ceremony to trade with your friends. The stethoscopes will be presented by the first-year advisors, Aaron DeCenza, Maureen Gajkowski, and Kathy Mone. Please hold your applause until all of the students have received their stethoscopes. And wait until your row is dismissed to come to the stage. Elaine Ahn. Hannah Alshami. Alyssa Anakin. Emma Baker. Robin Barr. Molly Chabowski. It's all right. All right. Amy Chang. Cindy Chen. Haley Clapp. James De La Cruz. Madeline Dempsey. Becca Dennis. Lillian Esterline. Anna Heineman. Caroline Hems. Molly Hobensack. Whitney Holm. Jenny Jong. Wendy Jang. Serena Cao. Jamie Law. Miriam Lee. Ellen Lays. Tung Ho Lin. Olivia Marino. Marcella Martinez. Bridget Mullen. Emma Muniak. Tree No. Mina Nguyen. Dori Nerzinski. Jack O'Brien. Shannon Orlosky. Margaret Orell. Sarah Park. Irina Priluski. Karen Rapandalo. Elena Riker. Paula Ryu. Gabby Shabo. Andrea Spielberg. Marjorie Speak. Emma Staley. Margot Swan. Allison Swartout. Eleanor Tihan. Krista Tedesco. Muji Tembo. Isabel Tenrero. Danielle Thompson. Nicholas Thomas. Michael Toms. Jill Tucker. Sarah Vanas. Samantha Finnick. Kevin Whittington. Yu-Wei Young. Elizabeth Van Goren. Terry Yao. Stella Zhang. Tina Zhu. Congratulations, class of 2019. I would now like to introduce Dr. Amy Beda, who will lead you in the Nightingale Pledge.
Good afternoon, everyone, and congratulations. Give yourselves a big round of applause. They finally made stethoscopes in colors other than black, so you'll have fun trading them up. Oh, somebody got a pink one? Even better. Okay, so now on to more serious business. We'd like all the freshman students and any nurses in the audience to please rise as we recite the Nightingale Pledge. The words will be on the screen, and there'll be no test after. Okay. Okay. I solemnly promise before all present to live my life honorably, morally, and to practice my nursing profession faithfully. I will never intentionally harm anyone in my care and will work hard to practice nursing safely. I will never take or knowingly administer any harmful drug or therapy. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. By active engagement, a commitment to caring, continued education, and mentorship of new nurses and nursing students. I will keep all health and personal information, patients and families confidential as I practice my calling. I will work collaboratively and respectfully with all healthcare providers and devote myself to the welfare of those in my care. So, oh, I was hoping somebody would say it. Well, good luck and best wishes for a successful first year. Okay. One more announcement. There will be a bowling pizza party for all the first-year students and their classmates at the corner alley on the corner of Ford and Euclid. And it's sponsored by Edwin Mays and the First Year Experience from Undergrad Studies as a congratulation to you guys. So have fun and enjoy.
Thank you. had something.
Oh, I'm offering, like, offer.
Jackson said it.
Yes.
Yeah.